have so much good energy. You're not spreading good. You come out
you're
here,
not spreading like, good you're energy. You're spreading toxicity, honey.
Hey,
Freelee.
Thank you for giving me an email.
Victim mentality. Ugh. Take responsibility for yourself.
Hey guys, it's Lavender here. Welcome back to my channel. It's Lavender here. And today I want to talk about something that I've never talked about on this channel. I want to talk about the toxic, privileged, white vegan, Freelee the Banana Girl, and why she is not a good person, and why I think that people need to steer away from her, honestly. So yeah, first I want to say is that I don't like Freelee the Banana Girl. I think that she is really toxic. She bullies people, like, who aren't vegan. She's talking about how there's no excuse to hunt and eat animals at all and all this. And she keeps giving, like, colonizer, like, advice and stuff. She's like, anyone could, you know, get vegan options. You have no excuse to not eat, like, vegan stuff. Like, you have no excuse to wear, like, fur coats. There's not one reason to wear fur coats and stuff like that. And just very toxic and stuff. She also, like, bullies people who aren't vegan. And she, like, she'll make, like, response videos and rating people's diet videos even though they don't want to be, like, rated about their diet at all. And then she gets offended, and when she gets offended, she, like, will, like, make fun of someone's appearance and stuff. I'm gonna show a few clips of her TikTok. This is why I'm gonna be talking about this, because I've seen how horrible her TikTok is and how she's bullying people and giving really bad advice, so I wanted to make this video so you can stay clear from Freelee the Toxic Banana Girl. Those bananas must be really toxic.
People in recovery can be vegan,
no,
can be
there's never an excuse
make
to take the life
don't
of an animal. Never
that is literally doing so much good.
Them alone.
This is the Arctic, where the Inuit people have hunted off the land and sea to survive. Now, we do have a store that ships in food via airplane and barge in the summertime, but the prices are prohibitively expensive. These are the prices in the Hub Community Store. Now, I want to let you know that the prices in the villages are sometimes twice these costs. Although we have these stores, not everyone can afford the food that is sold in them. This creates a great deal of food insecurity in the Arctic, and this is just what we have to live with. I mean, look, $60 for some chuck roast. I think a lot of people just don't realize how remote the Arctic actually is. This is my hometown of Otqervik, Alaska, and our way of life might be different than what you live and breathe every day. I just want you to respect that.
I don't give a fuck. Nothing will ever touch the era of peak vegan YouTube drama for me. Bitches were literally calling celebrities fat publicly for money, eating 30 bananas, cycling all of Australia, and then being like, there is literally no reason why everyone can't live this lifestyle. Like, that shit united people of different social groups along dispersed ethnic lines. Like, there was a time in the world where everyone could at least agree that Freelee was fucking insufferable.
So I had to turn this woman's voice off because it was so insufferable. This virtue signaling SJW pink iced cupcake has a problem with me. And so does a lot of weak-willed, mediocre, lazy humans. I mean, look at her. She obviously needs a diet and lifestyle overhaul. Yesterday. She's on TikTok. Why? For likes, validation from strangers, stroking that fragile ego. I'm on TikTok because I actually want to save lives. She basically has a diet of Cheetos and Starbucks, and calls my healthy, high fruit and vegetable lifestyle orthorexic. No one knows you outside of your TikTok circle, jerk hun. That's why you're using my name for clout.
I also want to comment how Freelee is talking about everyone should be vegan. There's not an excuse not to be vegan. But, like, I don't think that Freelee knows anything about, like, food insecurities or, like, food deserts or, you know, anything like that, because, like, if she did, then she would realize that some people don't have access to healthy, you know, fruits and vegetables, like she says. She keeps saying that anyone can do what she does, and there's not an excuse why no one does what she does. Very narcissistic behavior, honestly. Yeah. So I don't think I've ever covered food deserts on my YouTube channel, and I want to cover it because I think it's a really important issue and how capitalism creates food deserts and how capitalism is very anti-people of color and stuff. So let's get into why food deserts, just some facts about food deserts. So food deserts are a geographic areas where access to affordable, healthy food options like fruits and vegetables or frozen fruits and vegetables or whatever is limited or non-existent in an area because grocery stores are way too far away. About 23.5 million people live in food deserts. Nearly half of them are also low-income and people of color. Specifically, people living in the poorest social economic status areas have a 2.5 times the exposure to fast food restaurants as those living in the wealthiest areas. And as so, with limited options, many people living in food deserts get meals from fast food restaurants, increasing their high correlation and increased diabetes rates and low health rates and stuff. In Chicago, the death rates from diabetes in a food desert is twice that of areas with access to grocery stores. And now I want to talk about just some facts about food waste and capitalism.
Organic.
But guess what? The food is not only tasty, it's perfectly fine to eat or drink.
Still good. Cranberry juice, right out of the dumpster.
Why am I eating in all of these dumpsters?
Candy from a dumpster. Still good.
To prove a point, that perfectly edible food is going to waste.
And here it is. Check out all of this food we found thrown away before its suggested sell-by date, including this baby formula, which is still good for another month, and this grape juice, still good for at least 2 months.
I think it's outrageous and I think it's appalling.
And check this out.
Oh, wow.
At this CVS dumpster, we hit pay dirt.
All of this food came out of one dumpster from one CVS.
The manager wanted to know what we were up to.
If you take a look over here, this is all of the food we got out of this one dumpster, and it was still before the sell-by date.
Yeah, anything in a month before, we trash it regardless.
We told him the food we had gathered would be donated to the needy, but he insisted it go right back into the dumpster.
So you're not going to let us take this food?
Yeah, I'm not able to, I'm sorry.
But you understand that makes no sense, right?
Exactly, I know it doesn't make sense, but it's our company policies.
People say that capitalism is efficient. Meanwhile, thousands of food is trash along with like other products besides like food, like the Nike company cutting shoes instead of giving their shoes out for free to homeless people. Capitalism decides just to get rid of it during a crisis and stuff. Like, they'd rather just, like, not sell it and just throw it away than give it away for free. That's how capitalism is. Very cold, you know, very heartless, typical capitalism.